One other frequent error must be mentioned here. The illusion, namely, that love means necessarily the absence of conflict. Just as it is customary for people to believe that pain and sadness should be avoided under all circumstances, they believe that love means the absence of any conflict. The conflicts of most people are actually attempts to avoid the real conflicts. They are disagreements on minor or superficial matters, which by their very nature do not lend themselves to clarification or solution. Real conflicts between two people, those which do not serve to cover up or to project, but which are experienced on the deep level of inner reality to which they belong, are not destructive. They lead to clarification. They produce a catharsis from which both persons emerge with more knowledge and more strength. Love is possible only if two persons communicate with each other from the center of their existence, hence if each one of them experiences himself from the center of his existence. Only in this central experience is human reality. Only here is aliveness. Only here is the basis for love. Love, experienced thus, is a constant challenge. It is not a resting place, but a moving, growing, working together. Even whether there is harmony or conflict, joy or sadness is secondary to the fundamental fact that two people experience themselves from the essence of their existence, that they are one with each other by being one with themselves rather than by fleeing from themselves. There is only one proof for the presence of love, the depth of the relationship, and the aliveness and strength in each person concerned. This is the fruit by which love is recognized.